Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Now, I know what you're thinking. Alex, why do you keep dunking on PlayStation? Well, I'm not dunking on PlayStation. I'm dunking on the fanboys of PlayStation, you see, because recently, a lot of things have been coming to my attention. And the thing is, fanboys, which, scarily enough, they happen to be very old men arguing about plastic boxes and exclusivity on either Twitter or YouTube or, heaven forbid, Facebook, have been running rampant, and it's time to put a stop to it. But see, Saturday night, when I took the night off from streaming because I was doing things for the house, some really great news came across my timeline. And in fact, right here, according to VGC, we're seeing that PlayStation's Steam page is live and seemingly hints at more PC content. Sony's PC storefront lists 41 pieces of content, but only around half is actually visible. And if you think this is some sort of meme, in fact, ladies and gentlemen, here it is live on the Steam page. Now, it is in beta, so there are a few things that they're going to be working on. But as you can see, Days Gone is featured, Horizon Zero Dawn and Helldivers, as well as Predator Hunting Grounds. Now, there are going to be more pieces of content, all 24 right here, DLC 21, Games 3, but there are going to be quite a few things coming down the pipe. So let's get back to what the actual article is showing, and that is that PlayStation Studios' Steam curator page has gone live, and it seemingly hints at more PC content for the PS5 firm. Now let's continue with the article here, showing Steam curator pages allow approved companies or individuals to highlight games and content for sale on Steam. Typically, companies can use their curator page to bundle their own content into one storefront. PlayStation Studios lists 41 games and DLC associated with the Sony division, but currently only has 24 pieces of content are actually visible on the storefront. Currently, Horizon Zero Dawn, Predator Hunting Grounds, and Helldivers are the only PlayStation PC titles available for purchase on Steam, and Days Gone is set to release for the platform later this month. Now, a few things were definitely missing. And those games are Flower, Journey, Beyond Two Souls, and Become Human. Now, I do think that it's because the way those games were developed and published on Steam, they were done a little bit differently. So I'm wondering if this is only via PlayStation Studios logo and branding of how they're going to combine everything on their Steam store page. So that could be what's going on here. So don't be alarmed if those games don't show up on there. I'm thinking it's just the way that the branding for the PlayStation Studios logo shows and how they're going to be doing things moving forward. But look, let's really get into the fun stuff about all this. Let's talk about the crying, the incessant pandering, the screeching, the yelling from the incomprehensible, inconceivable, low IQ individuals known as the PlayStation fanboys. That's why you're here, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go to Twitter. So here is the Wario64 tweet. Gotta love Wario. He says, PlayStation Studios now has a creator page on Steam that you can follow. And the very first tweet right under that bad boy baby is, don't want to be a fanboy here, but I hope PlayStation doesn't go overboard and port everything to PC. Now, why would you want that? Is it because you perceive value in the thing that you purchased only if other people can't play those games that you bought a $500 console for? How moronic and idiotic and completely childish of behavior is that completely across the board? I don't get mad when PC exclusives go to console. In fact, I get excited because more people get to play those games. Whether or not you think they're trash or not is honestly irrelevant. The thing is that more people get to play the game gets to sell more copies, and then we can possibly get a sequel. Because Lord knows that Days Gone 2 sequel sure as hell isn't coming anymore right now, is it? And here is another incredibly 200 IQ take on the Twitter, baby. Fire Jim Ryan. Fire Jim Ryan. Fire Jim Ryan. Fire Jim Ryan. It's like it just doesn't end. All you care about is your ability to brag on Twitter about games other people can't play if they don't spend $500 plus on a plastic box that charges you for online connectivity, which will probably be replaced in the next year to 2 years for the pro version so you can actually get the specs and frame rates you were promised in the beginning. I don't understand this entire idea and mentality. Look, it's just a console, kids. That's really all it is. It's just video games. And the fact that you're consistently incessant on trying to play this one-upmanship about a corporation who gives nothing of a care about you at all. And this is the behavior that you do. You're literally doing free marketing for them. Why would you even waste your time, your energy, and your resources into something so moronic and idiotic about video games? It's one thing if you were like, hey, these are great games. Hope you enjoy them. They're going to be awesome. We played them on the PS4. We played them over here. They were a ton of fun. But no. This is the classical, this is my toy, no one else can play with my toy, childlike behavior. Now look, I don't want to do everything about bashing people about Sony, but Don't Pet My Goat honestly has a fantastic take. He says, I have every PlayStation to date. I suppose it's safe to say that I'm a big PlayStation fan, but some of you people need serious help. How can you be so mad that more people get to play games? That is so good. In fact, we're going to give this big bad boy a little heart. Because he's the best. That is a great take to have, because in the end, it is all about more people playing more games and having those conversations about those games and then trying to get better games to have everybody else play. The plastic box you play on is irrelevant, whether it's PC or console, it honestly doesn't matter. If you're able to have a logical, well thought out conversation about a game, how well it is, how good it is, why you liked it, why you didn't like it, that's more important than anything. Crying about a logo on a box and the fact that other people can't play that game because they don't have the same logo on a plastic box shows me where you are in your life. Lord, please stop. Get some help. It doesn't have to be this way. Like this guy right below it. I can see your achievements on your profile. You're the wrong you're a PC gamer in disguise. No OG PlayStation gamer that has all PlayStation has such low trophy achievements like you. All my 200 plus friends on PSN are from level 240 to level 500 with trophy achievements. That is so irrelevant across the board because I'm not gonna trophy hunt. I had a PS4. All I did was I played the game, I beat the game, and then I threw my PS4 into a lake because it was just god awful of a console. It made no sense to keep. And here we go back to talking about trophies and achievements. Look, the best thing about trophies and achievements is to figure out who in fact actually beat the game when they're talking about it. Not about how many you have or what kind of gamer score you have. Did you beat the game? Yes or no? Can you prove it? Yes or no? That's about it. Did you beat the game on the hardest difficulty and you're bragging about it? Let's see if you actually did. But the whole point of like, let me check your score and see if you're beating enough games or grinding out these idiotic trophies to get this dopamine Pavlov dog sort of like feedback loop is stupid. And that's not even an argument about how many trophies this person has. Let's continue though, because it gets better. He says, no, OG PlayStation gamers don't care about trophies. They just have every PlayStation console. You are a loser who has no life. Imagine getting blown out on Twitter this hard. No, you are losers that are rookie casual gamers. That's why you don't care about trophies. I bet your trophy achievements are low level. And yes, I'm an old school, hardcore player, PlayStation gamer. I'm 24 years old, baby. I'm old school with PlayStation and you don't have more games than me. You wish you did. Look, he got you, bro. That's pure logic. 24 years of PlayStation. So if you were 8 when you got your first PlayStation for 24 years, that would make you 32. That means you are a full-grown adult man in their 30s arguing on Twitter about trophies and achievements and exclusivity of video games for a plastic box on a console. Can you be more pathetic? I submit that you cannot. Here's another one. One of these individuals who's trying to make it out of a good news and just inhaling all that delicious copium that they possibly can. It's KO2MO3. I think this is a good move for PlayStation. I just hope Sony doesn't go and port all of it over. Why not? Why would that be a factor? Why would that be an issue? Why is other people playing more games a problem? Why is it that they shouldn't port over all their games? Because what? Because you can't cry on Twitter anymore? Because you can't pull out a list of exclusives on Twitter anymore? Because you can't make an argument about exclusives on Twitter anymore? Is that why? Is it the fact that now you can't just cry at Xbox and be like, ha, you have no games because you have no exclusives? because now you don't have any, if that's honestly the case. But even then, is that the only reason why you bought the console? Did you only buy a PS5 or a PS4 or a PS3 because of the exclusives, or the fact that you can brag about them in the first place? Because if you only cared about the games, this would be zero relevancy for you. Because you would literally be here playing games instead of being on Twitter crying and arguing about, oh my God, someone else can play the game without buying the console like I did. Here's another fun one. Keep dreaming, pirates and poor beggars. You'll get nothing special. You mean all your exclusives aren't special? Is that what you're saying? If you're saying we're getting nothing special, then all the exclusives that you cry with Metacritic about, saying, oh, this is a 90 plus Metacritic game, you're never gonna play it. If that's what you're saying, that means you're literally telling me every game we're getting is nothing special. Therefore, the exclusives that you use to brag on lists on Twitter are nothing special by your own definition of logic. Way to go. You got me. You won. They're literally nothing special. Congratulations, you played yourself. So look, I don't want to go too long into this video, but man, the salt is overflowing in the mines today, ladies and gentlemen, since Saturday. Now, if you did like the video and you like the channel, please subscribe. It does mean a lot. I will do my best to put out content on a daily basis. It may not always be like this, though. Sometimes I'll do news. Sometimes I'll do games that you should play, but it's always going to be something on the channel. And we are still live streaming the Devil May Cry series. We just finished DMC3 last night, and we're starting DMC4 this Sunday, as well as CSGO on Friday nights. So definitely keep checking out the channel for more. And if you do want to see even more, you can check out my Twitter and my Twitch. It's at Oh No, It's Alex. And if you want to join the Discord, the link is in the description down below. Hope to see you guys there. Thank you guys so much for watching. I do appreciate it. Hope you guys have a great one, and see you next time.
Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch!
Bullshit, Joe Hogan!